Let us pray the prayer for priests. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O Almighty Eternal God, look upon the face of your Son, and for love of Him who is the Eternal High Priest, have pity on your priests. Remember, O most compassionate God, that they are but weak and frail human beings. Stir up in them the grace of their vocation, which is in them by the imposition of the bishop's hands. Keep them close to you, lest the enemy prevail against them, so that they may never do anything in the slightest degree unworthy of their sublime vocation. O Jesus, I pray for your faithful and fervent priests, for your unfaithful and tepid priests, for your priests laboring at home or abroad in distant mission fields, for your tempted priests, for the lonely and desolate priests, for your young and elderly priests, for your sick and dying priests, for the souls of your priests in purgatory. But above all, I commend to you the priests dearest to me, the priests who baptized me, the priests who absolved me from my sins, the priests at whose masses I assisted, and who gave me your body and blood in Holy Communion, the priests who taught and instructed me, or helped and encouraged me, all the priests to whom I am indebted in any way. O Jesus, keep them all close to your heart and bless them abundantly in time and in eternity.
Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Please be seated. Good afternoon, sisters and brothers. Welcome to our celebration of the Holy Sacrifice of the Mass. Today we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Our Lady of Fatima. Our presider is Reverend Father Anjo. Please stand.
In the name of Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good afternoon, brothers and sisters.
Good afternoon, Father.
Welcome to today's celebration of God's love and mercy. As we celebrate the memorial of Our Lady of Fatima, let us ask God to help us to understand the powerful intercession of Our Lady in our lives. Let us also acknowledge our sins so to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that
I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, O Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who chose mother of your Son to be our mother also, grant us that, persevering in penance and prayers for the salvation of the world, we may further more effectively each day the reign of Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. While Apollos was in Corinth, Paul traveled through the interior of the country and down to Ephesus, where he found some disciples. He said to them, "Did you receive the Holy Spirit when you became believers?" They answered him, "We have never even heard that there is a Holy Spirit." He said, "How were you baptized?" They replied, "With the baptism of John." Paul then said, "John baptized with a baptism of repentance, telling the people to believe in the one who was to come after him, that is, in Jesus." When they heard this, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. And when Paul laid his hands on them, the Holy Spirit came upon them, and they spoke in tongues and prophesied. Altogether, there were about 12 men. He entered the synagogue and for 3 months debated boldly with persuasive arguments about the kingdom of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
God arises, his enemies are scattered, and those who hate him flee before him. As smoke is driven away, so are they driven, as wax melts before the fire.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
But the just rejoice and exult before God. They are God and rejoice. Sing to God, chant praise to his name, whose name is the Lord.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
The father of orphans and the defender of widows is God in his holy dwelling. God gives a home to the forsaken. He leads forth prisoners to prosperity.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
If then you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The disciples said to Jesus, "Now you are talking plainly and not in any figure of speech. Now we realize that you know everything and that you do not need to have anyone question you. Because of this, we believe that you came from God." Jesus answered them, "Do you believe now? Behold, the hour is coming and has arrived, when each of you will be scattered to his own home, and you will leave me alone. But I am not alone, because the Father is with me. I have told you this so that you might have peace in me. In the world you will be troubled, you will have trouble, but take courage, I have conquered the world." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, today we celebrate the memorial of Our Lady of Fatima. This apparition of Our Lady took place in 1917 in Portugal to the shepherd children, Jacinta, Lucy, and Francisco. The message of Our Lady's apparition can be summarized into three areas. She was asking to pray for the conversion of the souls. Secondly, she was asking to do penance for our sins. Thirdly, asking us to recite rosary always. The message has been summarized into these three areas. And if we do so, what will happen to us? That is what the reflection that we need to have today. And it will be starting from our first reading that we had from the Acts. When Paul reached a particular area, he was met some of the disciples and he asked them, "Have you received the Holy Spirit?" They said, "We have never heard of the Holy Spirit." Then he answered, "What kind of baptism you have received?" They said, "It is the baptism of the John the Baptist." Now he got, what is the difference now? He said, "There is also another baptism that you are supposed to receive. And it was the baptism that Jesus was teaching about." He said, "John the Baptist was giving the baptism, forgiving the sins. Then now, here is one that I wanted to give you, that has been given by the Lord, this baptism that leads you to eternal life. That is the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Unless and until we are guided by the Holy Spirit, we cannot understand the realities of this world. We cannot also understand the reality about the eternal life. So John's baptism is limiting ourselves to this world, whereas the baptism that we have received right now, the baptism of the Holy Spirit, opens the way to understand the realities of this world as well as the realities of eternal world." That is the teaching of Jesus in today's gospel as well. When Jesus started to talk them openly, the disciples told him, "We can understand now, and therefore we believe in you." Then Jesus understood the mistake that they had committed there. He said, "You are saying you can understand it right now, because what I am talking to you is limited to your own understanding. The faculty that you are helped to have understanding is helping you to understand. The human faculty that we use to understand is always limited to our own senses. With the five senses, we try to understand the things, the events, the persons, the feelings, emotions. But then Jesus is asking, there are some things that you need to understand beyond, that goes beyond your sensory powers." Then Jesus said, "Here is the time coming, because I will be taken away from you. And as they capture me, you will be scattered, you will be troubled. But then don't worry, I am going to conquer the world." More than understanding Jesus, Jesus is trying to understand his own disciples with the limitations that they have. And Jesus is trusting them. When we have proper understanding about the people, when we have proper understanding about the realities, when we have proper understanding about the eternal life, we will be always having a trust, real deep faith in God. If we are not really understood, we will be always looking for the evidences. And that very evidences will be limited to our own senses, which has already having a limitations, a limited area to be covered. So sensory knowledge is not going to help us to live unless it is oriented, blessed, purified by the Holy Spirit to have understanding that goes beyond our senses. And today, as we celebrate this feast, the memorial of Our Lady of Fatima, let us have go to the confessions, purify ourselves, so that we may do our sin, the penance for our sins, and start to recite rosaries, whereby we will be always guided with the presence of Our Lady in our life, so that as she understood the mysteries of the Lord in her life, as she lived her life together with Jesus, we may also live together with Mother Mary to understand the life mysteries that we are about to live. Thereby, we will be having a better understanding when led by the Holy Spirit into the eternal realities. Pause for a moment in silence. Let us ask God to fill us with His Spirit so that we may walk always trusting upon His guidance. We may face all the mysteries of our life having trust upon Him. Pause for a moment in silence. Let us ask for the necessary graces. Through the intercession of Mary, the Virgin of Fatima, let us pray for forgiveness of our sins as well as for all sinners, that the Lord may show us His mercy and grant peace in our days. Our response, Our Lady of Fatima, pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima, pray for us.
Through the intercession of Mary, we ask protection for the Holy Father, the Pope, for the conversion of sinners, and for peace in the world, we pray.
Our Lady of Fatima, pray for us.
May we pray with frequency and devotion to the Rosary of Mary, sweet chain which binds us to God, and bond of love which unites us to the angels, we pray.
Our Lady of Fatima, pray for us.
At the end of each Rosary decade, may we pray this prayer the Blessed Mother taught the children of Fatima. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins. Save us from the fires of hell. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of your mercy. We pray.
Our Lady of Fatima, pray for us.
May we consecrate our very being and our whole life to the Virgin Mary, Queen of Heaven and Refuge of Sinners, that we may share the benefits of her motherly blessing. We pray.
Our Lady of Fatima, pray for us.
May Saints Francisco and Jacinta, the seers of Fatima, intercede in heaven for all, especially for the children and young people. We pray.
Our Lady of Fatima, pray for us.
Let us pray in silence for our personal intentions. We pray.
Our Lady of Fatima, pray for us.
Lord, we now address to you the prayer that the angel of peace taught the three children of Fatima. My God, I believe, I adore, I hope, and I love you. I ask pardon for those who do not believe, do not adore, do not hope, and do not love you. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
Receive, O Lord, we ask, the prayers of your people with the sacrificial offerings that, through the intercession of Blessed Mary, the mother of your Son, no petition may go unanswered, no request be made in vain. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, to praise you, bless and glorify your name. In veneration of Blessed Virgin Mary, for by overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived your only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal life, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him, the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore and powers tremble before you, heaven and virtues of heaven, and the blessed seraphim worship together with exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, Lord, fount of all holiness. Make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world and bring her to fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Hosea Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who are pleased to you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. But only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. As we have received this heavenly sacrament, we beseech you, O Lord, your mercy, that we who rejoice in commemorating the Blessed Virgin Mary may, by imitating her, serve worthily the mystery of our redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please kneel and together let us pray the prayer for peace. And oratio imperata ad petendum fluvium. Lord Jesus, we come to you in our need. Create in us an awareness of the massive forces of conflict that threaten our world today, and grant us a sense of urgency to activate the forces of goodness, of justice, of love, and of peace. Where there is armed conflict, let us stretch out our arms to our brothers and sisters. Where there is abundance, let there be simple lifestyle and sharing. Where there is poverty, let there be dignified living and constant striving for just structures. Where there is selfish ambition, let there be humble service. Where there is injustice, let there be atonement. Where there is despair, let there be hope in the good news. Where there are wounds of division, let there be unity and wholeness. Help us to be committed to the building of your kingdom, not seeking to be cared for, but to care. Not expecting to be served, but to place ourselves in the service of others. Not aspiring to be materially secure, but to place our security in your love. Teach us your spirit, for it is only in loving imitation of you, Lord, that we can discover the healing springs of life that will bring about new birth to our earth and hope for the world. Amen. Our Lady, Queen of Peace,
pray for us.
Oratio imperata ad petendam pluviam. God, our loving Father, creator of our earth and of the universe and of all the wondrous elements of nature that sustains your living creatures, we humbly ask you to grant us relief from the extreme heat that besets your people at this time, disrupting their activities and threatening their lives and livelihood. Send us rain to replenish our depleting water sources, to irrigate our fields, to stave off water and power shortages, and to provide water for our daily needs. At your command, the wind and the seas obey. Raise your hand, Almighty God, to avert the continuing rise in temperatures so that your people can engage in productive undertakings and our young people can pursue learning in tranquility and comfort. Merciful and generous God, open our eyes to the richness and beauty of your creation and instill in us a deep love for this earth and all that is in and around it. Teach us to be wise stewards of your creation so that we may always use them responsibly and protect them from abuse and exploitation. At this time of crisis, dear Lord, move us to share more, to serve more, and to love more. Loving God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, you entrusted the Filipino people to the special care of Mary, our Mother. Listen to the prayers that we bring up to her, our Blessed Mother, to intercede for us, for the protection of our land and our people whom she loves. Grant this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Our Lady of Guadalupe,
pray for us.
Saint Rose of Lima,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calunsod,
pray for us.
Please be seated for some announcements. The Landas ng Buhay Ministry and Tirisian Association invite young professionals to a quieting prayer with the theme Listen on May 18, Saturday at 7 p.m. at the Serviam Hall. We also invite everyone to participate and support the Marian Corner activity, the Flores de Maria, a flower to Mary. Proceeds will benefit the Tulay ng Kabataan, or TNK, and Makabata School Foundation. This will run for the whole month of May. Thank you for your kind attention. Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.